They covered the gamut, but public safety dominated the debate between Mayor Frey and the top three challengers. It comes at a time when crime is on the rise in the city, and voters are also trying to decide whether to replace the police department with a public safety department.
We need to look at supporting our youth, especially.
The four candidates in today's WCCO debate are split on replacing the Minneapolis Police Department. Sheila Nazad and Kate Knuth support it, while A.J. Alwed and Mayor Jacob Frey oppose.
For me, the first priority for the next mayor, any mayor, should be getting more officers out on the streets. And that's exactly what I plan to do.
Yes, deep-seated accountability. Yes, a full structure change. Safety beyond policing, and importantly, we also need police.
Where Mayor Frey has literally seen officers hunting people in our city and has not yet created accountability within the MPD.
Kate Knuth was referring to the footage released during the Jahlil Stallings trial of officers firing rubber bullets at protesters from a moving unmarked van.
They admitted that they were hunting down protesters, that they were targeting groups of folks on the street.
So let's talk about each one of those with specificity.
Jacob, it's my turn right now.
Go for it.
The same four squared off Friday night on TPT's Almanac Show.
He's let things swirl around in a moment of crisis. And in this absence of leadership, we've had a lot of conflict despite unity underneath all of that.
What our city is looking for right now is a seriousness of governance. They're looking for a clear vision. They're looking for consistency of position, not flipping it back and forth.
Schools and social services are the things we've been defunding for years, while we've been pouring more money into policing and prisons.
We had nearly half a billion in damages in BIPOC businesses, right? This is a specific and failed leadership.
Now, there are 17 candidates for mayor on that city's ranked choice ballot, but they narrowed these, in both of these debates, they narrowed it down to the four candidates who have led so far in fundraising. Back to you.
All right, thank you, John. And Minneapolis voters will see three questions on their ballot as well.
And here's a quick breakdown of what they are. The first one would decide if the mayor's executive authority should be strengthened and take power away from the city council. Proponents say the goal is to help the city operate more efficiently. The second one you just heard about from John Croman, it focuses on whether or not the police department should be replaced with a new Department of Public Safety. And the third question focuses on rent control. A yes vote would give the city council the power to regulate rents in the future.
Well, voters in St. Paul will also vote on rent control. A yes vote would cap rent increases at 3% per year beginning May 1st of 2022, while landlords could apply for exemptions to cover unexpected costs. Landlord groups have said it will lead to poor maintenance of buildings and a housing shortage.